Hi, welcome to a video from RoboJax. In this video we are going to look at the features of the RadioLink 899 channel 2.4 GHz RC transmitter. You just plug it in and connect it. It's now rotating, but the direction is reversed. Has some value, you can fix that. So this is a package. When you receive the package, so the shape looks like this. Okay, so a Chinese certificate, whatever it is, I don't know what it says. A manual on the CD. So it comes with a port. I believe this would be the port that you can switch the sticks from left to right. Also, we got R9D, this is a 9-channel receiver. So this is the transmitter. It's relatively average size. Very well fit in your hand. The handle is metal, that's nice because you can attach a FPV monitor here. That's one of the advantage. This is from North America, so on the left side we have the throttle, as you see. So usually you understand the throttle by moving it to any position and it stays. So that's the throttle. So this is the other control that we have. Look at the back. So here we have a connector for some devices which I don't know at the moment. I have to look at the manual. So this uses 8 battery to power this up, so 3-cell battery will work. This is with the JST connector here. Connector is here, and for this transmitter, the Nanotech Turnigy 1.5 1500 milliampere will work perfectly. So using this servo cable, you just plug it in and connect it. You can see the positive is on this side and negative is on this side. So positive on the wall, negative is outside. So is the battery, and the positive on the battery is at the middle. So I'm just inserting it like this. If you incorrectly connect this, the transmitter will die immediately. Of course, unless there is some fuse to protect it. Let's turn on the transmitter. Okay, the best thing that you can see immediately is that it has a color screen. Many of the values that you see on the screen are color. That's the screen. On this side, we have two of the channels connected here, so this can be used very nicely with a gimbal to control a gimbal or position of a camera. That is very convenient and nice. We have four switches A, B, C and D. So the D has two position switch, the same as A has two position switch. B is also two position. We can see here E, F, G and H. So this is three position switch, so it has three position. This has push, so you just push and release. This is also a regular switch of two position. This is a three position switch. Some of the basic setup of this one, so we can use it with multi-rotor or quadcopter, whatever you have. So I'm just turning this on. And then let's go for the model select. If you see on the screen, if you wait for a few seconds or sometimes you turn it this on, you will see this screen. So when you see this screen, it says that push this push button. So this is a push button with a rotary switch. There is a mode button and end button. So I have to push this, so that disappears. Now mode button, if you press it and hold it, you will see the basic menu. And then if you press it again, you will see advanced menu. So let me go back to the basic menu and then go to the with the rotary switch. When we go, we can select different options. Any option that is highlighted is selected, it needs to be pushed so it can be accessed. So let's go for the model type. You see here it says reset, push for 1 second, or let's go here next for helicopter and then push. Now you can change it. You will see aircraft. And the sound of a multi-rotor screen also appears. So press for 1 second and it says, are you sure? Hold it. It says, please wait. So now it's aircraft. Press end to exit and end again. So now we are in multi-rotor or aircraft mode. Let's change the model name because you can have multiple models. Hold, model select, go up. Press enter, and as you can see here, if I go to the right, select that, sorry, and then go to the left, that is 15, which is the maximum. So you can have one, you see, multi-rotor, model 2 is such, and there are helicopters. So this is model 1, which is multi-rotor. I'm just pressing it. Come here for model 1, and then we can change this for quad, let's say. So press that, you see all this alphabet appears. So you select the value you want. Let's say you want to make this one blank. QUAD up to E is quad. So all of this should be deleted. So if you lose that time, just press that again. So I'm pressing that again until move this until you see that space. So that space, it has been selected. Press and go to the selected again. So I'm going here for Q. And then for A. QUA. That's capital U. Let me put small U. So let's say this is a quad and you accept it. Press exit and exit, and now you see quad. So you can have multiple models like quad 1, quad 2, black, red, whatever. Now let's to test that. I have the receiver here and I have connected a battery to an ESC and to a motor that you can see. And then you pay attention here. It says RX, that's the receiver voltage, which is being sent through this. So the ESC is supplying 5 volts here through the middle one to the receiver. But the signal goes back through the white wire. So when you look at this here, the negative is at the bottom. So negative, positive, and then signal. So this is negative, positive, and signal. So you insert it like that. Or if I put it, the white should be at the top. So the third channel is throttle. Let me put that there so you can see it. I connect that, the light is here and you see 5 volts. So this has a firmware, Psi Monkey, which prevents it. So I have to have at the zero. You see it's now rotating, but the direction is reversed. So I have to reverse it. Now let's see how we can reverse that. So first, this is saying the push. So push that. Mode button works in two, this mode. When you press it once and hold it, it goes to the basic, and press again, it goes to the advanced mode. I'm pressing it again. In the basic mode, this is a rotary switch, this go down. So you can select any option you want and then press the push button to select it. So mode, end, rotary switch, and then push. So I'm going at the reverse, push it. Now here you see aileron, elevator, throttle, that's number three. Throttle is connected to channel three, so that's why I connected the throttle into channel three. So that was the third one. So that is the normal. I'm pressing it and holding it. Now it's blinking. Normal. Let's go here. Are you sure? Reverse. Now it's maximum. So now the motor is. So, and so forth. So the other channels are just as you said that they will just simply work the same way, but you have to make sure that you have to put them in proper values. So this is channel one. You see by default it has some value. You can fix that the same way. And this is channel two, is also having some value. So at the middle you want to make sure that you have zero. And channel four is this one. Okay. 5, 6, 7, and 8 here are auxiliary for different, so you can assign these buttons to work with those channels. Now I have connected the motor through AC to the battery, and I'm going to show you how you can assign different switch to different channels. So this is switch A, B, C, D. As you can see, this is switch E and F and G and H. So those are already labeled. I'm connecting it to channel 5. This is channel 5, the light is on. And as soon as I connect it, you see here, you see 5.2 volts. Let me just disconnect it. That's the voltage of the receiver, RX. And also look there. So now the signal is coming. It's in channel 5. It's in channel 5. Press mode button once and hold it. This is basic menu and this is advanced. You need to be in the basic. With a rotary switch, just come to the auxiliary here and then press it. Now channel 5. So here on the auxiliary you can set all these from channel 5 and to 8. 9 and 10 is, this is the same software, so this doesn't have 9 and 10. It will be in the other one, in the other model. So again, so now go to channel 5 and then press it until it's blinking. So we will put SW. As you can see here, motor is rotating because there are different things are working. So that is switch A. When you see SWA, this switch A will work. So how it works is, in normal you can see here down and up, so we can change the mode of this. So when it's down, it should be off. So let's say, So that is switch A that works. So you can, the same thing, you can do the switch B. So for the same channel, you can set the switch B. So now it's switch B, switch B. So you can change the, okay, so here we can come and change the switch. So you see auxiliary 1, auxiliary 2. It can be either normal or fail safe. So how can we assign this one? This is variable switch A or switch B. So let me just go here. So let's assign any of these knobs to the switch or any of these variable sliders at the bottom also. So that's variable A. Now, so that is a variable A. If you want the B, just select it, make B here. The B. And the same thing, if I variable C is on this side and variable D. So the same way you can assign any of those switches, let's say this one switch H, and I want to put switch H at channel 8. So now I'm connected to channel 8. Go to channel 8 here, that's switch H. So that is switch H. As you can see, it works. So that's it, guys.